Countdown was directed by Justin Deck in his feature film debut and is about an app appropriately named Countdown, where when you download, it tells you how long you have before you're going to die. You could live to be 95, or you could have a couple decades, or you could have a few years. You could have a few months. You could have a few weeks. You could have a few days. Or you could have a couple hours, or you could even have a couple minutes where by the time you're done downloading the app, it kills you. This demonic entity, this evil entity that surrounds this app kills you because you cannot escape death's design. Death has a plan for you. Death is coming and you cannot escape it, and wait, that's Final Destination. That's exactly what this is. This is like a badly done app version of Final Destination, just only not as good. And it takes so many cliches from there. And don't get me wrong, Final Destination was a series that just went to absolute shit after like the first three. And even people could argue that number two wasn't that good. I think the first three were good. But anyway, at least with that, okay, it started to take more of a comedy element and this kind of stuff. And Happy Death Day and Happy Death Day to You, those kind of movies had fun with the fact that they had a stupid premise and everything. This didn't have nearly as much fun as it should have had. It was like Bedeviled or Amy. In fact, it was pretty much like Bedeviled. Because Bedeviled was about an app that, you know, made your life easier, but was controlled by a demon and basically would kill you. Okay, I mean, you know, granted, that's stupid, but that's what this reminded me of. The problem is this movie should have just been much more comedic and just had more fun with its premise, and it played it too straight. And I was excited because of the young cast it was in. Elizabeth Lail plays the main character, Quinn. She was in Dead of Summer. I thought she was very good in that and was excited to see what she could be in. Or what she could do in, like, you know, a feature-length movie. And even though I know she's been in other stuff, I was excited to see what she could do in a horror feature-length movie instead of, like, just a horror series. You have Jordan Calloway, who plays the character Matt. He's in Black Lightning. The character of Jordan is played by one of the actresses from Annabelle Creation. Not that you could tell I'm a fan of that movie, but I was like, okay, cool. And you got the doctor from the Twilight movies. It was somehow less creepy in that, despite being a vampire. And he was really, really creepy as a doctor here. And then other assorted cast members. But everybody's cookie cutter. And everything is pretty much generic. Painfully generic. Not scary. There's a jump scare bullshit. And not even good jump scares. Nothing's atmospheric about this. It all feels very stale. And all feels very mind-numbingly basic. And the problem is there's this overarching thing of, like, you know, what tragedy can do to two sisters and stuff like that. And I'll get to that here in a little bit. But between Quinn and Jordan, there's this overlying thing of, like, you know, loss and the family. And that could be something that they could play on and stuff like that. That's kind of, that's stuff that they could actually, if they wanted to go with a serious route, they could go with something like this. But the thing is, it's so hammy and so badly done and so badly written. The acting is not that bad. And maybe the writing was just shoved out really, really quick. And they basically just said, hey, you got like about 3 days to write this script, and that's what they managed to write out. And that's kind of what it feels like. I'm not going to knock the directing. The guy's doing the best he can in his feature film debut. However, I will say that the writing, I could tell that it was pretty rushed, because at one point in the beginning, there's this party scene where they're talking about apps and everything, and the Countdown app gets mentioned. This one girl says, I don't want to download it. And one friend says, well, don't be a biatch. I don't remember the last time I heard anybody in real life say the word biatch. I think I've said biatch more on this review than anybody else has said in their lives, or at least in the past few years. I don't remember the last time I heard that word and I was like, okay, is that what they think sounding, you know, what they think the kids the kids say? Is that what being hip is? Granted, I am not the peak of being hip. I'm pretty much in the goddamn earth's core. But seriously, that was just so goddamn... It sounds like a nitpicking thing, but then you get to the whole thing of, like, how they're trying to escape this app and everything, and how this app is coming for them and death is coming for them, or maybe something, you know, evil is coming for them. And it's just so stupid. And the way the ending is done, I'm going to get into spoilers here a little bit later, but everything, the way it's done, it basically sets up for a goddamn sequel, and I just can't believe it. I'm like, you had barely any material to stretch for 90 minutes for this. How the fuck are you going to get a sequel? But then again, dumbasses like me will pay to go see it because I love horror movies, and it will probably make its money back, because if this movie costs more than $10 million, I'd be absolutely amazed. Now, again, that's not knocking the cast. The cast did the best they could, a very cookie cutter and everything. But the problem is, this just wasn't very well done. It just wasn't. It was such a basic movie that did not have nearly as much fun with this premise as I thought it would. And even when it started to have fun with it, I'm like, okay, let's go in this direction. And no, we're going to deal with it seriously. Look, death is a serious subject, but in horror movies, some just treat them like, you know, treat death like it's like, you know, it is what it is. Final Destination is one of the few that hit that sweet spot of like finding some comedy among it, but keeping it serious. This just couldn't do it because it was a very, very razor thin plot. And it just overall wasn't that good. So now I'm going to get into spoilers. So if you're watching from 5:30 on, I'm in spoilers here. So if you've seen the trailer, you've pretty much seen the best parts of the goddamn movie. So that party that I referred to earlier, you have a girl, she downloads the app and like, oh God, she only has a couple hours left to live. She has a drunk boyfriend that was going to drive her home. And she decides to walk home instead. Well, then this app tells her, you know, user agreement voided and that kind of stuff. It basically just voids the user agreement. You know, you broke the agreement. Oh, why the hell did you break the agreement? Well, it turns out because she was supposed to die in that car wreck because he was drunk and she was supposed to die there. Well, no, death just ends up taking her and, you know, putting her up into the ceiling and then seemingly dropping her back on the bathtub where she breaks her neck. Okay, cool. And then you get Elizabeth Lail's character Quinn, who was a nursing student that became a nurse. And this plot unravels where the countdown app, she downloads the countdown app and then finds out that she only has a couple days left to live. And then she's got this stuff going on with her dad and her sister because their mom died because she snuck out one night and everything. Quinn did. And she's always blamed herself for it. And that's an overlying theme and stuff like that. And this demon, it turns out to actually be just an advancement of this biblical gypsy curse. Where this gypsy curse this, what? Get into the story and you'll figure it out. It's not really that important to remember all the details. But with this gypsy cursed somebody and said, okay, you're going to die at this point. And if you don't go along with the plan, you try to break the plan, you're going to be tortured and everything and all this stuff. And okay, so, okay, granted, that's what's happening. Well, Quinn meets this guy, Matt, because she tries to get a new phone at the store. That doesn't work because the app ends up right on back on the phone. And the phone store owner guy actually ends up being factored in later in the movie. And I guess something comedic, but okay, so they find out from the pastor or from the preacher at the hospital, you know, because they always have one there on call, apparently. He tells them, hey, there's somebody I know that could help you if you've got a demonic presence, if you fear a demonic presence is around you. So sends it to this weird comedy guy that finds out, okay, hey, you know, we could do this. And oh, I hope demons exist and this kind of stuff. I hope you guys don't die. But it's a lot of misfired comedy and misfired scares. And it turns out that there's this angry demonic presence that just wants to kill. And it has done it through this app. And it's absolute bullshit. It's fucking bullshit. It's fucking stupid. And there's this overarching thing where Quinn got hit on by the main doctor, but then she got away from him. But then he said that she came on to him and then she got suspended. So suddenly that just frees her up to go off and pursue and do all this stuff and figure out why death is trying to come for her. And it's just, I put way more thought into this than clearly anybody, you know, making the movie did. And again, that's not to say the cast and the crew and everybody didn't work hard, but the studio put no thought into this. They just said, okay, guys, go out and make this bullshit movie. See ya. Because she's a nursing student, of course, at one point, well, she was a nursing student and now a nurse. At one point, she's like, wait a second. Would they find out from that, you know, the guy that's this nerdy pastor guy, wait a second, if somebody can either die before their time, it breaks a cycle, kind of like breaking death's cycle and everything and all this. Well, so she tries to kill the doctor. And it's just so fucking stupid. It's so fucking bullshit. She tries to kill the doctor. Matt, at this point, actually, they think they've escaped it. They paint this weird demonic circle thing in like the church basement and put this rock salt around and try and keep it like that. And Matt had stolen a toy from his brother, his sick brother, and then, of course, like an idiot, thinks, wait a second, I see my brother. Even though I know this demonic presence is here and taking the form of whatever, steps outside the circle, he gets taken, and then, oh wait, I've survived, and then he gets run over by a truck. But it's not nearly as effective as the bus scene from Final Destination 1. And then Quinn ends up trying to beat the shit out of the doctor. That doesn't work. And then she decides, wait a second, I'm going to kill myself to save my sister. And that if I kill myself before I'm supposed to die, then that breaks the cycle somehow. And so, okay, that happens. But then she puts this little, you know, thing for her sister to take this, drug and just put it in her. And then she wakes up, but wait, that breaks the cycle because the demon's dead and everything, except it's not. We get to the next scene. The doctor, apparently, by the way, just walks away. But then it turns out that he wasn't just sexually harassing her, trying to rape. Quinn, it was others. And then, okay, they're reading, you know, the father's reading and saying, yeah, it's good that he's going away. And then suddenly Quinn looks at her phone. Oh, God, countdown 2.0, the demon's back, the demon didn't go away, or it's another demon, or the phone just says, you know what, fuck it, I'm going to just scare everybody. Technology taking over. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. This movie was not very interesting at all. And then they allude to a sequel where the guy that was in charge of the phone store is on this Tinder date, and then because he downloaded the countdown app, he gets killed. So they're pretty much alluding that they're going to do a sequel. I didn't really care for this movie. It was not very enjoyable. D+. It just wasn't that entertaining. The reason I say D+ is at least the cast tried. They did. But D+. Poll maybe above my head. If not, let me know what you guys think in the comments. Like, share, subscribe. Twitter handle in the description. I'm John Ritland. I'll see you soon.